Hello guys and welcome to a brand new video. Today I'm here with A Place Further Than the Universe, episode number 13, reaction, and this is the final episode of this anime. Alright, the previous episode, Shirase starts to get a little bit worried about, actually going to the place where her mom went missing, and she was a little bit, kind of thinking about the whole situation, kind of wavering. Her determination was kind of wavering, and she actually interacts with a lot of people, for example Gin and all her friends, and she comes to a realization that when Kimari says when they were sleeping that if it was not for you guys, I probably wouldn't have had as much fun, and I probably wouldn't have even come here. So you guys are the reason why I'm here now. And that made her realize that, yes, I have friends now, people who will be with me. And that's why, she wanted to go with her decision. She has done this up until now, little by little, gathering money and everything for this, for coming to Antarctica, go to the place where her mom has been. And now she has been wavering. So she, in the end, came to the decision that I will go to that place and, and I will, do what I have actually set out to do, because if I don't, in the future I might regret it, definitely, because this is Antarctica. You cannot come here just like that. This is like once in a lifetime opportunity, and if I miss it, I'll probably regret it. So she they go to the place, arrive at the place, and then we see her friends and everyone actually going in and trying to find out if her mom left something. And they found out a laptop with her picture in it, and when it was turned on, all the messages started coming in, and that's when she breaks down. Her friends outside also breaks down, and yeah, that was a really well done scene. I was not expecting the mails to start coming. That was totally unexpected, and because I thought that the mails, she was writing them and saving them or something, but she was sending them. I really did not realize that, but as soon as the mails start coming, and the amount of mails that are coming, more than 1,000, I realized, she has actually been sending letters to her mom every day, each and every day. And that's when she starts crying, and her friends, and it was a very emotional scene, and it was really well done. And let's see what this episode actually brings. And maybe we're going to go back now, probably pack up and go back, something like that. I'm guessing is going to happen, because this is the final episode. Let's see what happens. So yeah, this is the final episode, episode number 13 of A Place Further Than the Universe. So yeah, without further ado, let's get started. I'll be putting the subtitles and the timer here, link it to whichever is your preference, and let's start. Okay, here's the countdown. 3, 2, 1, go. Okay. Oh, she's in the dude. Okay, she's in the menu dude. Food waste. Please may eat your sardines. Okay, I wasn't able to read it. Wow. Oh, okay. Who was on duty yesterday? Clean the bathrooms. Summer team leaves in 3 days. Oh, 3 days are left. Okay. Onions. Wow. Wow. Which, okay, that they're playing mahjong. Wow. Yeah. Then, oh, interviews, okay. Oh. So we stroll, okay, around. Wow. Ice operation. Wow, they don't even listen to her. Oh, okay, that's why. Ice operation. Oh, wait. Oh, so we're gonna do. Okay. That's really fun, I get, or I don't know. Shaving of these big blocks of, oh, interesting. Forbidden to remove things from. Oh. Okay. Wow, 10,000 years ago. Okay. Little penguin. I can't imagine how cold it will be here at winter. Are they doing soulmen? Okay. Yeah. Or Aurora, we like, you know, if you come here then. Yeah. I wonder if they'll come back in the future, you know? Our team. There you go, Aurora. I was just. Exactly. Whoa, okay. Stink. Okay. On the frozen sea. Still. Yeah. Hypothetically. What? I don't think that's. Go. Yeah. She's gonna go hibernate. Yeah, and what will they do? Like, food and everything, yeah. They maybe they can come back in the future. Yeah. Yeah. There you go. All right. Yeah, it will be kind of a shame if they actually never see the aurora after coming to Antarctica. So maybe later on they can come back again. Before we leave, I wonder what. Okay, that's nice. Wait, what's that? Is that. Okay, wait, there. Wow. Oh, damn. One can dodge them. It just hurls that at the people. Oh. Okay. You know one thing I can say this as well. If you think the baseball as her. Okay, I'll talk about this later on. Oh! Yes, the after image of her mom. Okay, it's beyond home run. It's just okay, nice. Like if you think about the ball as like, you know, her feelings, she actually hurt her feelings. Okay, I'll talk about this one later on. Okay. Like her mom? Farewell, summer day. Remember us when you're home, okay. Where's Shirase? There she is. Yep. Yeah, oh wow, this is the first time she has laughed this big. Yeah. No swapping. All right. Major experiment. All right. Okay, one thing I understood. I wasn't able to understand that before. So these people are staying here. They're just like that's why Kimari was saying that we could live here after this as well. I was thinking like wait, like and they won't have food and everything, but no. These people will be here. Positive feelings for Antarctica. Okay. Wow. Wow, look at the scenery, my God. Yeah. Like all the characters' feelings there, like, you know, inner, like each and every character. It is true, their feelings were just. Yeah. Wow. Yeah, this is the. All right, time to go, I think. Oh. Wait. Oh, look at that. Wow, that's a interesting penguin. She's a fan, yeah. There you go, yes. Yeah, obviously, like. Okay. First, oh. Well, yeah, like this whole thing was, yeah. True. Oh. Oh, the laptop, I think. Yeah. Wow. Okay. Yeah, she's looking forward, you know. Obviously, she is going to get reminded of her mother, and she will have fond memories of her. But that won't stop her. She will move forward, keeping that in her heart. And that's the biggest thing that she realized after coming here. Like, you should not let the past actually stagnate you. You should keep, like, you know, keep the past in your heart and keep moving forward. Precision jumped. Yeah. She's reading them. Out? What? Out? Yeah, and they've decided to come back again, you know, in the future. So Wait, do we see the aurora? I think so. Oh my God. Oh yeah, we're coming back from the poles. So it is possible now, I guess. You know, the day and nights will be more. Okay. Oh, is it the male? The real thing is 10,000. Wait. 10,000 more. Oh my God! So that last scene, she okay. I realized what happened. When she was saying like it's so beautiful, she probably snapped the picture and tried to send it to her, but it didn't go. It was in the outbox up until now, and Gin saw it and then sent it to her. Oh my God. Wow. I'm sure there's something, maybe like an epilogue or something. There should be. So, yeah, it's still too early for the episode to end. All right. Okay. So I think there is something left. There you go. Okay. Who is this? Kimari? Yeah. N obviously not. Wait. Oh, wow. Oh, it is in that place. Okay. Ah, no. They're back. Oh, it's autograph. Oh, this is the opening scene, you know? All right, let's see. Megumi, I'm sure she's going to. There you go. Wait, what? Whoa! Wait, what? Wait, she's in the Arctic? Oh, wait. Whoa, what the hell happened in the end? So wait, so I'm guessing she probably does like an expedition going to the Arctic as well, and she joined that? Yeah, most probably. And since you know, like it will be the opposite of the Antarctic. It's night over there. That's why she like you know she was able to snap the picture of an aurora. Oh wow, that's interesting. Okay, so I was not expecting that honestly in the end. I thought like you know maybe she's like you know, they're going to meet and everything. They'll have to wait, I guess. Okay, so this was the final episode of Place Further Than the Universe. And yeah, this anime has been an experience. The final episode kind of ties up all the loose ends, and you know, like we get, you know, like we see the actual conclusion of the all the characters, what they have gone through up until now, and what they have realized staying in Antarctica, and what you know, like they are going to do from here onwards. So. Okay, so first we see like them in the duty in the food duty, and yeah, everyone was like you know like talking about food and all, and all the other like you know like for example Hinata and like you know all they were like assigned different duties. They were doing their duties, and we see like there's 3 days left for the summer team. Now I had a misconception in the beginning. I thought everyone was going to go back. So I didn't realize that they'll be here. So I thought that everyone's going to go back together. So that's not what happened. The summer team go and I think that's why they said like you know that usually what happens is the summer team gets exchanged with the winter team. But since there's no winter team, like you know we're throwing like a farewell party and you people will be the only one who will be attending here. Something like that they said and. Yeah, that makes more sense now. Like they will be here while the team will go back, and if there was a winter team, they would come here, join them, I guess. So, okay, now we can see like you know them doing all the other like you know the dudes like Kimari sayings like things like oh the vacuum cleaner makes you think of home while Shirase is like you know playing mahjong. Yuzuki, they went out to for some interviews and like you know, they're talking about the islands, like an you know, island stroll. Hinata's mad that she was not included in it, but she's like, "Oh, I'm going to do the eyes operation later." And they're like, "Nah, the eyes operation, everyone's going to attend that." And okay, now interesting. When they said what, they're going to do the eyes operation, I had no idea what that was about. But so basically, they take back blocks of ice, I'm guessing. Okay, so we go to a place where there's like a lot of ice. We see them actually, kind of using pickaxe to kind of take little portions of the ice, and they say like it's forbidden for to remove things from Antarctica, but the only thing we can take is the ice, and they're saying the ice is full of air that's tens of thousands of years old, and when they get released or when it melts, it pops. So interesting. I never thought about it. It's true. The air that is probably trapped within the ice is supposed to be very old age. It's supposed to be like tens and thousands of years ago. Like when they said it, I realized that yeah, that's true. And wow, that's kind of interesting if you think about it. They ate eating shaved ice using that ice. Okay, now okay, now here's one thing, they kind of talk about the whole night and the day thing, about how it's day here for most of the time, but we only get a little bit amount of night because because of we're completely in the south. And it does make sense because there were scenes we were seeing in the previous episodes as well where it kind of became evening. So what happens, I'm guessing, is basically it's day most of the time. For most probably 2 to 3 hours, they kind of go into a little dark phase, which is kind of like an evening, and then they go again to the morning. Now the little dark phase would also disappear completely if this was completely in the summer. So they would have complete light, but I'm guessing since they are they are in a time when it's neither summer nor winter, in the middle of it, that's why the time limit where the daylight is on is kind of reducing, and it'll completely turn into night as we go to winter, and that's what is going to happen. So we are getting a little bit of night, but that's for a very less amount of time. It's kind of like the evening, and then we go back to day. So they kind of talk about that, and yeah. So okay, now Chase is happy with the penguins. Okay, and all right, and Megumi, I think Megumi, that was her name. She says like, okay, like you guys decide. This is obviously this will be our final time being here. So you guys decide what you are going to do, and. Now here Kimari says something. Kimari says like, okay, can't we stay here, like, and here she says no one else needs the rooms and we can keep sending video from here, right? So there's no reason we have to leave right now, is there? So she's saying like, yeah, we can stay here. Now this at this moment I really did not know that the other team members will be here. I thought everyone's going back, so I kind of got confused. I was like, wait, why is she saying this? There'll be like food problems and everything. Like, how can they stay here alone? But then that kind of got clarified when I realized that, oh, they're not leaving. The summer team is only going to leave, and they'll be here. That's why Kimari was saying like, yeah, couldn't we stay here longer? And she says like, yeah, I bet when it gets dark I could sleep forever. But everyone's like no, it's not possible because we have our own life. We have people waiting for us back home, and school, graduation, this and that, all that stuff. So yeah, we cannot stay here. We need to go back. So then they kind of decide. Kimari says like, all right, then in the winter, in the future, we will be back. We still have auroras to see, this and that. We will be back with four of us. And she actually makes sure everyone says yes, especially Shirase. She's like, I'm serious. Like, this is not a joke. And Shirase's like, yeah, I know. Like, I'm also serious. We are going to be back here. And all right. And then they like make Kimari says like, all right, we know what we're going to do for the last request that we have. So they basically wait. Oh, I realized what that was. You know, they were kind of showing little cartons. At first, I thought, was that milk? But no, I realized what it is. It's the powder, the powder or whatever, the color that you put on the shape dies. They used that to make the markings for the baseball, like, you know, match they had. And I realized it now what it was. Okay, so now they were like, yeah, we're going to play with everyone. Like, that's what we want to do. And they started like, you know, the baseball game and everything. Like, this part was really good because Shirase, she takes a place, and Megumi also said to her that Takako was the only one who was able to return back the ball which Gin threw. So now here's the thing. This part I kind of see it in a very different light manner. I feel like, you know, like up until now, we've seen how Gin and what's her name, Shirase, both of them had like, you know, had like a very good relationship before. Even though they were kind of quiet, like, you know, with each other, still they like, you know, talked. They had like a good time. You know, the flashbacks when we saw when her mom left her with her. So I see this scene as like, what can I say? Like them again, you know, like going back to the same relationship. Like up until now, after like, you know, her mom's dead, the whole thing was a little bit kind of like, you know, was the whole situation was a little bit awkward. Like none talked to each other, and it was a very like, you know, like what can I say, sad situation. Because you know, like Gin thought like, oh, she probably blames me. And while Shia said like, you know, didn't want to converse with anyone, because especially again, probably because it would remind her of her mother. You know, that's why both did not talk with each other, and like, you know, it was a situation. So now, like, you know, this scene where we see her coming into the baseball pitch and Gin throwing the ball towards her, and she returning it back to her. This I see it like this. Like, this is like a new start for them. No, it's as if the ball is like her feelings, you can say, I don't know. And Gin actually hurls it towards her, which she returns it back to her. And this is like a new start. And when she threw the ball, we could see like, you know, her the after image of Takako, like she saw returning the ball to her. So yeah, that scene was really well done. And the ball goes out in the sky, and yeah. Now here again, the next scene, here's another interesting thing. Shirase says, cut my hair, and they cut her hair. Now here's one thing, like I do know, like girls, I think they cut their hair whenever, like, you know, either usually it's kind of because when they get their heart broken or something, you know. That's why in the, like, you know, the later part, one of them says like, wait, did you have like a heart broken or something? That's the reason. You know, a lot of girls do that, like when, like, you know, they kind of get rejected or something, they cut off their hair. Because like, as far as I know, like hair is like, you know, I think like there's like a saying, like the hair of a girl is like their life or something like that. So to like, you know, show that like, yeah, like I'm like, you know, I'm over that heartbreak or something, they cut that hair. And so not so what is like you're cutting the hair? If you think about it in a more simplistic way, cutting hair means change. And you know, like it means I'm over it. I can move forward. So in that manner, if you think about it, Shirase's cutting of her hair, I think at least, actually indicates her moving forward and not, you know, getting like, you know, stagnant because of her past. The past has always been kind of making her hesitate and, you know, kind of stand in one place. And she knows that. And like, you know, now after like, you know, getting her feelings like, you know, all in the open, as they say, like an Antarctica brings out your feelings. She is like, yeah, I'm ready to move on. I'm ready to change. And that's why she cut her hair. So this is obviously nothing romantically, like, you know, related. This is just a change. This like, you know, shows us that, yeah, she has changed, and she made up her mind to move forward. And cutting off her hair, I think that's what it denotes here. That's why she decided to do that. And I don't know, this is just like, you know, this is just how I saw the scene. So yeah, she cut her hair, and, like, you know, they went out, and they go out. Gin was extremely, not only Gin, Megumi was also surprised. And wow, this scene was really nice, you know, when she takes her helmet off and she looks at them and she's like, well, does it look good on me? Then she smiles, and yeah, she really did look like Takako, you know, like the way she smiled over there. And Gin is like, yeah, like mother, like daughter. Now here, like, you know, here's when we get to see, like, them kind of standing there, and they say, like, we, like, you know, usually we would be swapping the teams from, like, you know, summer to winter, but this time there's no swapping, so this is just a farewell party for the departing summer team. And here's where I realized that they will actually be here, you know, this is where I realized that, like, these people will be here, and the team, the summer team, our team, are only the ones who are going to go back. So yeah, they, like, you know, they say, like, we're going to give, like, a little farewell party, a little speech and everything. And first Gin talks about how it is a excellent weather for departure, how, like, you know, like, obviously, like, you know, that our team was definitely, like, you know, what do you call it, nervous about this whole thing, because obviously this is completely new for them. Antarctica is a big deal. And no, well, okay, here we go. Let me read that part just a sec. Okay, Japan's first high school aged Antarctic research team members. This was a major experiment. I'm sure they were all nervous. We were all very, very nervous too. But they did an excellent job as expedition members. The male team members' internal wishing for them to stay has been so loud it's audible. But they are going home. It's time to give up on them. Okay, yeah. So yeah, she kind of gives her little speech, and then she says, like, you know, after you go home, I hope you'll occasionally think about us. And yeah, she gives, like, you know, the mic to Shirase, and here Shirase talks about how her mother loved Antarctica and she came here because of her obsession. And she, like, you know, like, how Shirase also came here, and she thought, when she came here, she thought that, yeah, I would not like this place because this is the place which took my mom. And she, you know, like, she thought about that, and that's why she decided to come here. And here, this part is really well explained. Where is that part? This is, like, one of the best parts of the speech. A place further than the universe. My mom called it that. It is a place that strips everything bare. Time, life, hearts. It's a place with nothing to protect you and nowhere to hide. It's an environment that exposes everything we are embarrassed about and everything we want to hide. And so, naked and crying, we are forced to come face to face with who we really are. We have overcome trial after trial together. And from that, I think I now understand. The reason my mother loved this place was not just this scenery, this sky, this wind, but also the time she spent here overcoming things with her team. She loved this atmosphere where you have no choice but to overcome things with your team, with nothing else to get in the way. I love this place. Good luck over the winter. I'll be back again, I swear. So yeah, this part is so well, like, you know, like I said, like, she says, like, this place is so big this Antarctica, like as if you see it, like, you know, coming here, you see how small you are, and all your insecurities and everything gets exposed, and you know it comes out, and we are like, you know, just like, we just feel helpless here, and we just like, you know, we're just stripped bare in front of everyone. And you know, we overcome that, and that's basically what happened here, right? From the beginning, you know, like after they came here, not only after they came here, but on the way as well, each and every character, their problems kind of came out. For example, wait, I feel like Kimari didn't have any type of, no, Kimari had one, the whole thing with Megumi, yeah. You know, that part, you know, that whole thing, like Hikimari with Megumi, the one I think who went to a massive, like, you know, change was Hinata. I feel like she went to the massive change. Hinata went through a roller coaster of emotions while coming here, like, you know, that whole passport situation, and then the whole the her friends coming and trying to speak with her to make up that those two. You know, and those two were both of, like, you know, she was heavily involved with Shirase as well in that, in those two, like, you know, situations as well, and she overcome came that, you know, she overcome came her problem as well, her feelings came out. Yuzuki, it's the whole thing with her, like, you know, thinking about whether we will be friends after we stop hanging out with each other, this thing, this, like, you know, like this whole, like, you know, situation that also came out. And Shirase, obviously her biggest you know, what do you call it, like a thing that her actually being stagnant this whole time, and she thinking that, yeah, if I come here and come to the place where my mother was, maybe I'll be again start I'll be able to move forward again. She also experienced that, and she came here and she was able to overcome it, and you know, like got like went to that place, got her mother's laptop, and she was able to move forward after that. All these things, these so many characters, their character development, all of them, that happened because of Antarctica. And yeah, like then she says, like, I'm sure my mom loved this place, loved the atmosphere, loved the wind, loved everything about this place. But at the same time, her friends, her, like, you know, team who was with her, she loved to overcome all, like, you know, the odds and all the different situations with them. You know, that is also one of the major part of why my mother loved it here. And yeah, this speech was really good. And she's like, yeah, I will be back again in the future. And yeah, I'm sure, like, you know, all of them will be back in the future. Like, you know, like maybe they're going to see auroras, and maybe it'll be night the next time. I think they will come winter. Next time when they'll come here, it will be winter and it'll be night then. And that's what's going to happen. So, okay. Now, after that, they start giving, like, you know, them gifts, like them food, and that girl gives them gives them like a sweater for Yukun. Oh no. And yeah, and then the other girl, I don't remember her name. The glass and glasses girl, yeah, she gave gives Shirase a picture of a penguin who's pretty pissed off. Shirase is very happy, and you know, they take like an autograph, the guy who's very who's a big fan of Yuzuki, and she again, you know, he says like, good luck with the drama. And you know, like Megumi, as she realized before as well, like, you know, I will definitely do the drama because there's a lot of people actually waiting for it. And yeah, I should not, like, you know, let them down, because yeah, they are my fans and they're anticipating this. Okay, so all right, and then like they talk with Megumi talks about how she was afraid at that, like, you know, moment of about the whole situation. It was like a tricky situation, you know, like the whole pressure from the upper, like, you know, like departments and all, like them actually whether the expedition will be you know, like will be successful or not, will that even happen, all these complications. She was stressed, but she says, like, you know, after talking to them in the van, she got courage. And yeah, she says, like, and most of the times adults should not be honest, And that's why she, like, you know, like gave them assurance that yeah, it will happen, definitely. And there you go. And then final, like, you know, the final person, Gin, she has her hands over her laptop to her, and she says this part. She says, what did she say? Like, I'm ready to, there you go, I don't need it anymore. Yeah, she's ready to move on, and that's it. She gives it to her, and she's like, yeah, I'm ready to move on. This should be with you. And she, you know, she they take the helicopter, go away. And yeah, like, this is the thing, you know, like, I was just saying this. Past should not be something that stops you or stagnates you. It should never be something like that. Past, you know, like, I'm not saying like forget about your past. That's obviously not the thing. No, you should definitely remember your past, but remember it in such a way that it actually gives you courage to move forward, not make you fear for the future and stop. A past should never, like, you know, like you should never look at the past like that. If thinking about the past actually makes you afraid of the future, no, that's definitely not how you should, like, you know, you think about it. So this is the change that they got. You can say everyone got this thing. Like, you know, not only Shirase, like, you know, even Hinata as well, and, you know, like Yuzuki, you know, everything's like, you know, like they also like kind of tackled their past. Hinata about, like, you know, the past situation. Yuzuki about, you know, how she never had friends. That's also something happened in the past. And, you know, her fear of whether they will be friends or not in the future. Like, all these things. And Shirase, like, you know, obviously Shirase is the one who dealt with her past in the, you know, the most. And, you know, when your past is something that stagnates you or stops you know, try to, like, you know, change it and make it something positive. And that's what they did here. And, you know, like, your past should not stop you, but it should give you courage to move forward. And that's what happened. And that's what she, like, you know, Shirase is, like, you know, at that point. She said that I don't need it anymore. That doesn't mean that, you know, like, and you can also see it like this as well, you know, like, she's saying like, I don't need a physical proof of my mother to, like, you know, help me move forward now. You know, I know my mother's feelings, and I have that in my heart, so that's why I don't need this anymore. That's why she, you know, you can also say it like this. She gives it to Gin, and, you know, like, she doesn't need that physical reminder that yeah, my mom loved me, or something like that. She knows that herself, and she's ready to move forward with that. That's why she handed that to Gin as well. You can think of it in that way as well. So yeah, her past, she was able to convert it to something positive, and obviously she's definitely going to remember her mother. She's obviously not going to forget about her. She has fond memories, and she is, like, you know, like, she loves her mother, so she will remember that. But that will not let her stop, but actually help her move forward from here onwards. And that is, you know, the biggest thing that they got from Antarctica, from coming here. Okay, and then they're like, you know, off on the back to the, like, you know, going back. And here we see Gin opening the laptop, right, you know, like, kind of seeing everything. And she sees an outbox. And I think, like, in the outbox, yeah, like, if some message doesn't get sent, it gets saved to the outbox, I think, yeah. So the outbox, there was like one message, and she then sends it to them, and they were like, you know, at that moment they were going back, and it was night over there. As I said, like, you know, they were going back from the pole to the, like, you know, equator, the direction of the equator. So the time of day and light is going to be shortened little by little. So that's why they got night over here in that moment, I'm guessing. And excuse me, they, you know, look at the sky, it's aurora filled. They lie down, and that's when the message comes in. Shiase opens the message, and this letter, mail from mom, the real thing is 10,000 times more beautiful. And like, now I re at this moment I realized that scene, you know, where her mother sent, you know, like, sent, not sent, sorry, yeah, send the thing in the walkie-talkie. She said like, oh, it's beautiful, and that was like her last words. At that moment, she probably took a picture and sent it to her daughter, which never went through because, you know, like, I'm guessing there was no signal or anything like that. It never went through. It was always in the outbox. So, yeah, that's what happened. And I realized that at this moment. And she has also probably realized that. And it's really, like, you know, nice, like, you know, to, you know, like to come to the realization that even in her final moments, she was thinking about her daughter. And yeah, Shirase, the message goes to Shirase, and yeah. Then we see the end credits. And then after that, a little bit of an after credit scene where Kimari says that, all right, we should probably split up here. Now, this is an interesting thing that Kimari says. Kimari says like we should split us from here, and Yuzuki's like, wait, we won't be friends anymore. He's like, no, the opposite. It means we can be. It means that even when we're not together, we can be together. Interesting way of, like, you know, this part, the kind of explained it. I, as far as I could understand here, Kimari meant that it would mean that even when we are not together, we can still be friends. That's why we should split up over here. And as she said, like, you know, we have our own duties to do, our own life and everything. So us splitting up doesn't mean we are not friends anymore. And like, that's the main thing that Yuzuki was thinking about, you know, like she thought in the previous episodes that if I take the drama, I won't be able to spend time with my friends. And that means we won't be friends anymore. This thing. And Kimari said this because, you know, like she wanted them to know that even if we have our own things, we are going to do our things. Like, obviously, this is life you're talking about, you know, like we don't have, like, you know, everlasting friends. It's impossible. People who we, like, can spend time with when we were children. And at that moment, probably we thought that, oh, these people are my best friends. We are never going to, like, you know, separate ever in the future as well. But now, like, you know, sitting here, you realize that, oh, like, it's been so long and we are not in contact anymore. This thing, like, people are going to come, people are going to go away. There will only be a few amount of people who will be with you forever, which is basically your family, you know, your spouse, your parents, and, you know, your siblings. These people are only bound to you by something even more, and they would be with you forever. Other than that, all the other people, they will come and go and come and go. And you're definitely going to meet a lot of friends in that way, and, like, make a lot of friends. And, like, you know, if they go and, you know, like, if you're not, like, you know, in contact anymore and everything, you should realize that, yeah, we are still friends. It's not that our friendship is broken. We can, like, you know, meet up again in the future. And I guess this is what they were talking about in this part. That's what Kimari meant to say. Like, she's like, yeah, we have our own things to do. And after everything, like, you know, is over, we are going to go back there again. And yeah, that's really, like, you know, that's the truth, you know. Like, I also have a lot of people who I was friends before. And now, like, you know, I don't have any contact with them anymore. But that doesn't mean that, you know, like, if someday they come into contact with me again, like, you know, and I start talking, it wouldn't mean that, yeah, we're not friends anymore. We are friends. And, you know, we have been friends forever. And there will also be a lot of people who, you know, like, have their own things. They'll do their own things, and then we'll meet up again and, you know, like, do things together. Like, that's friendship. And yeah, that's the main thing that Yuzuki needed to realize. And I'm sure she realized that. Yeah, because Yuzuki is, like, you know, main fear that if I stop, you know, like, hanging out with them, maybe I won't be friends anymore. That's not true. As long as the feelings never change, you know, if you'll forever be friends. And then they say, there you go, we still have a lot of things to do together. And it's like, yeah, when we are done doing that, let's go on another journey. The four of us. Oh, and here's another thing that was kind of like a twist here. They say, like, oh, wait, Shirase still has her 1,000,000 yen. And Shirase is like, it's all gone. And she's like, I left it there. And we see, you know, like, that place. She wrote on it treasure, and the two gloves is in that. And she left it there. And You know, like this part, I feel like, yeah, this is like an appropriate end to that because she actually made that money for, you know, like this expedition. This, you can say this money was probably like, you know, her symbol or whatever, personification of her determination, you can say. And she never got to use that money. So, like, you know, obviously, I'm sure a lot of people will say, like, oh, that's a waste. You know, but I don't know. I feel like this was like appropriate. Like, you know, she actually left it over there just by writing treasure because, you know, like it that money was supposed to be used, but it never got used. So, you know, like taking it, coming back and using it means on something else. I don't know. Like, you know, and so I think like, you know, this was appropriate. The ending where she they left the money over there. I think this was very appropriate. And like, you know, like I'm. Like, you know, like all the other girls, they were like, what? They were like, you know, but I'm like, yeah, that's better, you know, like I'm happy with that decision that Shirase took. And okay, and the final part, they talk about how everything here, you know, like is like here you go. Kimari says, when you go on a journey, there are things you learn for the first time. That this scenery is indispensable. Yeah, like nothing's better than home. You know, that's also something that you got to know. Obviously, the place where you go is might be very beautiful, but at the same time, there is a place which is, you know, like which is like way above that, which is your home. You know, like this scenery home is, you know, in my house, like, you know, not house, sorry, in my hometown. This scenery is indispensable. That people change, the world changes, even when you're not looking. Yeah. That there's no such thing as a nothing day. That your house has its own smell. And we kind of get to see, like, you know, what everyone is doing. Okay, let me check what they are doing. First of all, we see Kimari going back using the train, and Shias is also in on a train. And I'm guessing they're going back home. Yeah. We see Yuzuki, her mom coming and hugging her. Yeah. Okay, Hinata, we can see in front of her store, there's like a lot of, I'm guessing, news articles with their pictures and everything. Yeah, and she's just looking at that. And I'm guessing the store manager came in and she gave him a souvenir, I'm guessing, or something. Kimari has went back, and you know the mom and dad is there with such a huge pudding and all rice. God, Kimari is so happy. Her sister is also there, and Shirase, you know, in front of her mother's picture, puts like a glass of. I'm guessing that ice was the Antarctic ice, I think. And she, you know, her grandma's also there. She prays. Hinata goes to the shrine to put offer, like, you know, put an offering and pray, probably for her upcoming exams. And Yuzuki signing autographs on the train station. And here another shock comes in. I was really not expecting this. I knew like she was going to talk to Megumi after this. She messages her and she's like, "Oh, too bad, I'm in the Arctic." And I'm like, "What?" So I'm guessing she probably within this time she probably like, you know, like she was like, "Yeah, I also want to go somewhere like that." And she also like she you know like she realized like she has her own path as well. And she probably like, you know, just went into like another expedition like them and joined a team and went to the Arctic. And Hinata's like, what? Hinata was probably like looking forward to meeting her. And yeah, like interesting thing, you know, like you can say that Megumi, you know, in the previous episode where we see her character development and with Yuzuki's not Yuzuki, sorry, Kimari's. You can say that at that moment, Kimari was the one who left her behind and moved forward. You can say, you know, that was the thing. And that's what she didn't want. That's why she was like, you know, like it's like, you know, circulating those rumors, this and that. And you know, she was clinging to Kimari, and Kimari, you know, like was able to move forward. And you can say that, yeah, she left her behind. So this time, after Kimari comes back, Kimari realizes that she has left her behind this time and moved forward. So yeah, you can say, you can think of it like that as well. Yeah, that's it. Fantastic, like, you know, anime. I was really not expecting this anime to actually tackle so many things, like human emotions and like, you know, like all these like little problems which we all must have felt sometimes in our lives, or maybe will feel in the future. So it was a really great experience. I really expected when I started this anime it will be something only where we get to the Antarctica, kind of move around, you know, like a slice of life-y thing. Yeah, have you seen if you guys have seen what's the name, Yuzu Camp, I think that was the name. Yeah, Yuzu Camp. You probably know, you can, like, it's like a very like, you know, chill slice of life, like, you know, situation where they kind of go camping, kind of hang around. I thought it will be something like that. I never realized they are actually going to deal and tackle with so much, so many like, you know, human emotions and so many things. It was a big surprise, and oh boy, I can realize why this anime is so highly praised, and I realize that now. Fantastic, really well done. Well, yeah, that's it. Thanks for watching, guys. This was my reaction to the final episode, episode number 13 of A Place Further Than the Universe. So if you guys enjoyed this video, be sure to press the like button, subscribe if you're new to the channel, or you haven't subscribed, comment down below anything you want to say, anything you want to let me know, and I'll check them out. So yeah, that's it. So obviously this is the final episode. This will be replaced with some new animes, and you know, like spring 2022, a lot of new animes are going to come, and I'm going to replace this anime with one of them. While I made a poll, if I remember, and Nichijou came, I think I won the poll. I am going to react to Nichijou, which I'll probably start from the end of April. You know, that's when I've decided to do it. So yeah, that's like, you know, like this, like, you know, this is like one thing I'm going to do, I'm guessing, like do at least one poll, you know, like, because this anime as well, this anime won in that poll. That's why I started reacting to this, and Nichijou also won that poll. So I'm going to do Nichijou, and after Nichijou ends, I'm going to do another poll where there will be a few other animes, you know, like I'm going to do it like this. Like there will be at least one poll, and you know, like whichever will win, I'll do that. I'll do it like this, you know. So yeah, anyways, just wanted to let you guys know. So anyways, thanks for watching, guys, and yeah, I'll see you guys in the next video, in one of the next animes that I react to. So yeah, see you guys then. Until then, goodbye and have a nice day.